Do you want to learn coding and become a coder? Do you want to code for fun? Then I'm here to help you with your coding journey. My name is Ronak and I make coding tutorials on this channel, so consider subscribing. Now let's begin with today's topic. Today we are going to learn list methods in Python. List methods can be very useful while playing with list. Now let's begin. Here there are many things we can do with list. For example, we can check how many elements are there in the list. We can add items to list. We can delete items in the list. We can sort the list. We can reverse the list. We can clear the list, or we can count them. So let's begin the first one. Now length list name. To get the number of elements present in the list. Suppose I want to know how many elements are there. So what I'll do is I'll just count manually 1, 2, 3, 4. But that is donkey work. To do that with Python, what you do is there is a function called len. So len and then any list name which you want to count. So I want to count my list. And I want to print it, so I'll use a print function. There you go. There are 9 elements in this list. Next one is dot append. If you want to add items to the list at the end of the list, so how you'll do it is you'll just do my list dot append and what you want to add to it. So which element you want to add, you'll just write there. I want to add Python to it, so I'll just write Python. So this will get added at the end of the list. Now let's try printing the list. Print my list. See, you got Python at the end. Before it was not there. Now let's go to the next one, which is pop. Dot pop means you can delete any element at the end of this, at the end of the list. Let's try that. My list dot pop. Now if you do this and if you print my list, you'll see that the last element is gone, because by default dot pop deletes the last element. But for some case you want to delete the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th element. You want to delete the 5th element. So how you can do it is my list dot pop and then the element number or position. So 5, I want to delete the 5th element. Okay, and then let's print that. See, you see 75 is gone from the list. Next one is sort. You can sort elements by alphabetical order or numerical order. So let's try that. Suppose I have, I'll create one more list and I'll name it my list 1 is equals to Ronak and Aditya and Ron. And then suppose Sam, then Harry, and then Percy. Suppose I want to arrange them in alphabetical order. So how I'll do it is I'll just take that list, which I'll have to run it. I'll take this list, which is my list 1 dot sort. But they don't return any value, so you can't do print list dot sort, because they change the list permanently but they don't return any value. So if you print list dot sort, nothing will happen, or you can store it in a variable. Now let's print the list, my list 1. Let's see that. See, originally it was R A R S H P, but now it is A H P R R and S, so it's arranged in alphabetical order. You can do that with numbers also. If you have like these numbers, then you can arrange them in numerical order. So that's dot sort. Let's go with the next one, which is dot reverse. You can reverse the order of the list. For example, you have my list 2, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Suppose I want to reverse it. Suppose I want 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I can do that by dot reverse. Let's check that now. My list 2 dot reverse. Let's print that. My list 2. And you got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go with the next one, which is dot clear. Now you can empty the list. If you want the list to be empty, you want to delete the list, you can do that. Suppose I want to delete this list right here, my list 2. I can do that. My list 2 dot clear. And then I can just print my list 2. See, I got nothing. But see, the variable is not deleted, it is just emptied. So it is a difference. The variable is not deleted because it is not giving us errors, but it's empty. Okay, so you understood? It is not deleted, but it's just empty. Now let's go with the next one, which is count value. You can count how many elements are there. For example, count 34. To count how many 34 are there in the list. For example, suppose I create one more list. My list 3 is equals to Ronak Python and then JavaScript and then Ronak again and then Sam and then again Ronak. Suppose I want to count how many Ronaks are there in the list. Okay, I want to count number of elements, number of Ronaks in the list. I can do that by using count value. So my list 3 dot count. What do you have to count? How many Ronaks are there? Let's try that and you got 3. Because there are 3 Ronaks in the list. See, 1, 2 and 3. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment that I love Python. Now, I'll meet you in the next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.